We're talking about high availability and talking about how we can achieve the high availability of entire Hive service by adding availability at different service levels. So in this video, we can take a look into Hive Server 2 high availability, how we can implement Hive Server 2 HA by adding more Hive Server 2 service. And we are using the Zookeeper service mainly here. So okay, so this provides this, there is a feature that is called dynamic service discovery. So that allows this Hive Server 2 to register with Zookeeper, and client connects with the Zookeeper directly rather than connecting to Hive Server 2 services. So this Zookeeper will return that Hive Server 2 information, so which are registered with this Zookeeper service. So this feature is called dynamic service discovery, and it provides load balancing as well as high availability. So if you connect once, so you may get one Hive Server 2, and maybe next time another person connects, he will be getting some other Hive Server 2 instance like that. So also in case of failure also, it will try to connect whatever the active one. So this feature provides load balancing as well as high availability, and that is called dynamic service discovery. And we are using Hive Server, we are using a Zookeeper service to connect with this Hive Server. So we can take a look into the configuration part now. So go to the Cloudera Manager window, select Hive, then go to instance. So here I have only one Hive Server 2 instance. So I'm going to add two more Hive Server 2 instance. So add role instance and select Hive Server 2. Select any two, because I already installed Hive Server 2 on this 240 machine. So I'm going to add this one into two more machines. Just add, then finish. So that's it. Now I can see I have two more Hive Server 2 instance. I can start those instances. This takes some time. Okay, so it's started. Okay, so Hive Metastore server, which I stopped for some testing purpose earlier. So let me start those service also. Okay, so it is started. So now you can see I have three Hive Server 2 services. Okay. To work dynamic service discovery, I need to change in configuration. Go to the configuration, then go to the advanced. Then you need to search with this keyword. So Hive Server 2 advanced configurations snippet for Hive Site XML. So it is nothing but we are adding a customized or custom value to Hive Server 2 configuration. Okay, so this is the one advanced configuration snippet for Hive Site XML. So you can expand that and add value name and values for that. For that, I have just noted down the value, parameter Hive Server 2 support dynamic service discovery. So this feature allows Hive Server 2 to register with a Zookeeper, and we use Zookeeper service to connect rather than connecting Hive Server 2 directly and using true. And description is again optional, and you can leave final also. I'm not selecting, so default. I just added Hive Server 2 support dynamic service discovery to true. Save these changes, and it whatever the affected services, I need to restart. So once it is done, it's asking Hive Server 2 or Hive service to restart, right? So this value we have added, so that's why it's asking for us to do a redeploy and restart. Okay, so now I restarted the service, and so everything looks good. Now I can go ahead and do the testing. So the first thing I need to check is I need to identify the host name, or what are the hosts where my Zookeeper service are running. So I need to make a note of this IP address, because I use Beeline and this IP address, because I will show you how that we can use for connecting. So just like make a note of the IP address that we use, I mean that we installed Zookeeper service. Also we need to note down the port number for Zookeeper is using. I think it is 2181. Yes, the client port is 2181, so you need to make a note of this IP address also. So now we will try to connect this Hive server to instance using Zookeeper, I mean which is in effectively using dynamic service discovery. So let me use the Beeline. So I can use everything in a Beeline -u flag, or just use the Beeline then connect and using that JDBC string. Okay, now I can use the connect JDBC colon hive to colon slash slash. So now I need to use IP address and the port information of my Zookeeper service. So this is here. Okay, so because we have a Zookeeper running on more than one servers, so that means three servers. Okay, so it almost looks same. So JDBC colon hive to colon slash slash IP address port comma IP address port comma IP address port comma. So we have three server and last use slash then semicolon. Okay, so normally we use Hive server to IP address and then 10,000 port. Instead of that, here I am using Zookeeper service IP and port information rather than using Hive server to. So if you have multiple Zookeeper service, or if you have one or two Zookeeper service also, you have to use that all the available Zookeeper separated with comma. Why? Because again, so this ensures the availability, high availability for Zookeeper also. Why? Because if one of the Zookeeper service goes down, so it will try to use the other one. And next we need to use this option service discovery mode equal to Zookeeper, and then Zookeeper namespace equal to Hive server 2, right? So till here whatever the information is IP address and port information of the Zookeeper semicolon, then service discovery mode equal to Zookeeper and the Zookeeper namespace equal to Hive server 2. Use this information. Okay, and okay, sorry, it's asking for the username and password. Okay, so let me do it in a single line as it is. This one I already tested, so maybe some typo in my previous command. Okay, copy that and type it here. So this is also same, so everything I'm writing in a single line. I think one of the instance like unknown host exception, so unable to connect to the server. Okay, so something in the typo. I'll have to correct that. So I have corrected that, and so using this one, so this also the same thing only. So because in the host name section, so I made some mistake, so I'm just using this new connectivity. So I'll be adding this connectivity string in the description box also, so you can just use this one and change your IP to do that, right? So here it's connected to 240, right? So this is the Hive server to information, and if I am just using show databases, yes, it's working fine, right? So let me get the commands again. Okay, so log into some other user. So switch to user 2 and execute, right? So now it's connected to 165, but here it's connected to 240, right? So if I connect again with another user, so that will be connected to some other user also. Okay, so it ensures a high availability as well as the load balancing. Okay, so it's connected to 33 is there, and the second connection it went to 165, and the first connection, I mean here it is tried to, it connected to 240. So these are my Hive server 2 instance. You can see Hive server 240, 33 and 65. So what will happen? So if any one of your Hive server 2 goes down, then it will, okay, suppose if I am stopping all this Hive server 2 service, and again if I try to connect from some other machine, okay, so it will connect to the working one, I mean whichever is available. So I just stopped this two Hive server to only 165 is available. I'm trying to connect from here, so it will definitely has to connect to that existing one, right? 165. So even if I try to connect from this user to, so it also has to connect to 165 only, because 165 is only available. So this ensures high availability as well as the load balancing. So with the help of Zookeeper and dynamic service discovery, so we can achieve high availability and load balancing of Hive server 2. Okay, so this ensures even if some of the Hive server service is down, we will be able to use the service by using or by connecting through Zookeeper service. So I hope you are clear on this topic, and if you have any questions, so please use the comment box. I will try to answer that. Also, if you like the video, so please click the like button and subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. Thank you. Bye.